APLD in the data center market has been growing super fast, and AI is getting powered by what are this new infrastructure that we're seeing evolve very quickly. And whether it's for mining crypto or it's for providing the services and infrastructure to run ChatGPT, the data center companies are ones we love to look at and trade. Let's jump into it. Recently, APLD reached $40 a share, up to $40.08. That was this morning before pulling back down to as low as 35, and we see it start to recover. It's been stabilizing and using this previous resistance as a support. If we pull up some of the charts, you can see how it's consolidating and still holding this bull trend. There's a resistance around 40 bucks. It's kind of struggling to break up above, but it's now stabilizing around that $35 to $40 range. Why is this good? Well, with most data center companies, I don't know if you guys have seen, but basically every single data center company has seen growth this month. If they haven't seen growth, maybe the financials aren't lining up, but even companies that don't have the financials fully lining up are still seeing growth in the data center market. So when identifying value, there's three things we look for in a stock. The first thing is the market. So when we're looking at the data center market, you've probably heard that the infrastructure for AI is largely contributed to from data centers. So that's basically what powers your ChatGPTs, your Groks, everything else. If we look at the data center market size, it says that it's at $269 billion, and estimated to grow to $584 billion in 2032. I think that's just flat out wrong. This one says it's projected to reach $527 billion in 2025. Again, I think that's totally wrong. Most of the estimates are not even close to what we're currently seeing from the opportunity of data centers. I mean, if you look at the revenue increases from stocks like, you know, AMD, AMD recently had focus on data centers, and they've surged to $233 a share because there is very large demand right now, extremely high demand for AI infrastructure, so data centers. And if you look at the companies like, for example, APLD that we're looking at here, you know, they haven't even shown the financials really. They've seen $64 million in revenue, and their balance sheet did increase last week when they reported earnings up to $2.4 billion. But we're talking about, like, this is just APLD, a small data center company. They just signed, there's an $7 billion deal with CoreWeave. Then you have $500 billion for AI infrastructure with Apple. Then you have the Stargates recent pledge with like OpenAI and Oracle and all those companies. And that was, I think, $500 billion. And so the data center market is way, way bigger than most stats are saying. I don't really know what's going on with like Statista or Fortune, but like if we just take a moment and we actually go look at all of the companies, like some of the estimates are around like 270 million or something, or 70 billion. We're way over that. They must not be accounting for like Bitcoin mining. Like, do they know data centers? The data center market is also like the Bitcoin mining market. Like, this is the same. So you have a lot of companies that build for Bitcoin mining that also end up setting up their servers and their GPUs and everything else to act as a data center for big tech to tap into. And I don't even know, some of the estimates of the market are like 84 billion. I think data centers right now are around a $1 trillion market cap. I mean, if you just look at Nvidia, we're seeing big growth there. They're at like $4 trillion market cap, and they primarily focus on GPUs that are powering the data centers. So the reason that we bring up the market is because it kind of ties nicely into the company's market value that they're providing. You'd see some of the news that has come out too, and this comes out to the second step, which is analysis. In the analysis stage, we break it down into A, news, B, financials, and C, the charts, the technicals. When we look at the projections for APLD, a lot of their funding has been super easy. They've gotten some $3 billion. There's a $3 billion data center there was an extension to the CoreWeave deal that jumped it up to $11 billion. So they've got like $14 or $15 billion basically in the pipeline right now for building data centers. Now, if we look at Applied Digital's news or what they've been bringing to the marketplace as of recently, you can get an idea kind of where they're focused. They're definitely focused on using wind energy and solar power to make their data centers really effective. If you look at the APLD data center kind of philosophy, they work with liquid cooling. They go directly to the point of renewable energy sources. So again, wind energy or solar energy. And then you have where they're building. They're building in cold places and they're minimizing the carbon footprint. Now, compared to most, I guess, traditional data centers, and they kind of have a black and white view here, but it's pretty clear that most other data centers don't have liquid cooling. They are probably built in a place like, hot Nevada desert, or maybe over in Austin where it does get hot in the summers, or in Phoenix even, where it's not very good for efficiency in the summers. They're building their data centers over in the cold. So like places like North Dakota are pretty common for data centers with Applied Digital. And they've got partnerships with the top AI developers in the world. You got NVIDIA, Dell Technologies, Supermicro Computer. So they do the racking systems, all these big companies investing in them. So then you get into, okay, news looks good. Deals have been pretty good. As far as press releases go, they've also been raising some money, which is fairly good. That just means they're increasing their balance sheet. But then let's get into the financials. The financials, you've seen, again, $2.4 billion on the balance sheet. So they're increasing. You can see that big increase in assets quarter over quarter. And then annually, the revenue is up 84%. Now, the revenue is still pretty small, around $64 million. When they just signed deals that are $10, $12, $15 billion, and they still only have $64 million in the last quarter in revenue with a negative net income, so their financials haven't caught up yet. But they did start to see a little bit of stimulus in this last quarter. They jumped from $38 million in revenue with a negative net income of $50 to up to $64 million. And a negative net income of just 18.5. So revenue's increasing. They got to fix that net income as that revenue's increasing, because it doesn't really make sense. Obviously, they're construction. They're building out the data centers. So there's a lot of maybe liability in that they got to, buy the materials. And there is some higher liabilities in construction than there would be in, say, software industry. But overall, the financials look good. You see them, if they got $10, $15 billion in pipeline of deals and their current market cap's at $10.4 billion, then most likely we could see them continue in the long term here to continue to grow into that $40 to $50, maybe even $100 range, as they are in a hot market, as we mentioned. They're powering AI. So that's kind of the financial side. And then the other financial side to consider is going to be the institutional buying. If you look at some of the institutional buying here, and we can actually also pull this up over here in Mercatus. Let me jump in and get an AI analysis here. But if you look at the institutional holdings, 49% held by institutions. So you do have pretty large institutions like BlackRock and Vanguard and Goldman Sachs investing more in APLD. Slightly poses risk for downside more, because the more institutions own, the less spread out it could be. And when institutions sell, and they usually do sell multiple institutions at a time, it's going to be pretty impactful. If you look at other stocks that maybe have 5 to 10% institutional ownership, sometimes that means that the institutions haven't found this stock. They haven't found the value. Now, obviously, now that they've jumped from $3 a share when we started covering them, it was just April that they were back here around $3 a share or something like that. And we've seen them continue to grow, getting up to $40 a share. So basically 10xing. Obviously, in that time, we've seen institutional ownership. But here's what's going on. So they're trending upward. They've had a very consistent trend since those $3 a share. And we see them break up and break out. Now they're in a new trend. When we're looking at the current trend, they could continue to break out for sure, but they do have this established kind of resistance level that they're seeing here right around this $40 price point. And they did just sell back down to the moving average. Now, just note, in a bullish environment, a lot of times, not always, but a lot of times, when we're looking at the moving averages, that green line shows us we're in a bullish momentum. If it's holding above that green line, that moving average. If it's below, it crosses below that green line, a lot of times it's going to sell off more, if not enter kind of a bear market till it can cross back over. And that's usually how these moving averages function. You can see, like, in a bull market, that green line, moving average, it's going to be holding above that green line. It's going to be acting as a support. So when they get into the technical side of things, they recently pushed up pretty big. RSI was way overbought this morning at $40. They sold back down to this green line, this moving average. They did bounce right here and they started to hold that level. So nearest support is most likely right around that level, that $35 range. You can even see, you know, some of the support levels kind of acting out here in that green line there. So around $35.50, that's probably the nearest support. We did see in the recent movement that's, you know, they've been holding hyper bullish. So it's possible that's the support and we see them, you know, rocket even higher. But the conservative estimate would be, yeah, again, we got that support there. If we're going to see a pullback potentially, maybe down to that $35 range, which is a 3.8%, or down to potentially $34 a share, that would be the next level of that rising support, give or take kind of that zone. And then obviously very conservative and getting back into a trend. Maybe we see investors say, okay, they got the big contracts, but because it hasn't shown up on the balance sheets or on the financials as much as we would expect, maybe that's, you know, a conservative sell down back into that $29 range. So according to Mercatus, which is an AI-driven app that uses all of the data sources that I normally go through, so the exact analysis I just took you through, going through the market, going through the news, the financials, and then C, which was the charts. We actually run all that data through this AI here, and we're able to actually have it pair with, for example, Grok, and we feed the data into Grok, including SEC data and real-time data, to get projections on the stock and kind of see why the stock is projected to go the way that it's going. And I use this quite often. It's a tool that I personally developed with our team. We have an amazing team of developers. We have a gentleman named Ryan Potts and his brother, Jeremy, who's very skilled. And then also we have, you know, I do a lot of the UI, but as far as the everything that I do, we basically put into this so it does it for you. And so we have an analysis and we have a future chart kind of here. And we can go ahead, I can search, for example, it looks like correction potentially over the next hour. We could see that play out. As we're just saying, you know, it did just start to reach that $40 resistance and sell off. How's the next week look? Looks like it's fairly bullish. If you look at the next 3 months, this thing's projected to get up into $40 or more. And so we're going to keep a close eye on it. Again, in this market of data centers, they're growing fast. There's a lot to be watching, including some of the data that we're considering right now, which is the government shutdown. Not really going to impact data centers as much. Does impact more of the defense market, which we'd want to watch here. But when it comes to the analysis, if you want to get access to this tool, you can get it on the first access list and the first link in the description. Let me know your thoughts on Applied Digital. I have some long-term positions. We're looking at this $35 support here. Most likely going to see it hold that level. We would like to see that level be held and potentially get even higher back up into that $40 range. We're just going to be monitoring it, see if there's any opportunities for shorter-term trades. We were just trading BITF yesterday. That was a stock we traded at market open. We actually ended up making a 25% gain on BITF. So it was yesterday, right here at market open, $4.69. We bought at $5 a share. I don't know if I can, my order, you can kind of see it here. If I move my camera, there we go. I don't know if you could see. We bought 974 shares at like 503, and then we sold today at 606 this morning. So one day trade, and we actually were able to make about 23% as a result of trading this data center company. So we like to trade data center companies. That's another data center company we're watching. And if you ever want to learn how to invest in the cutting edge technology like AI and data centers, semiconductors, robotics, space tech, defense, then I would encourage you to simply take a look at the second link below. We do trade live every morning. If you want to join us in, tune on in. It's the second link below for StockMates, and you can surround yourself with other investors and get a free t-shirt when you join. There's about 27 or 28, excuse me, individuals with a net worth of over $1 million there. And we also really focus on results. If I go in there, you can see we have the targets. Next live trading is happening tomorrow. It's private, it's outside of YouTube. It's something that's, you get an email for each link, but even testimonials are rolling in. David just has recently basically 203% on his account in 8 months. He said, I did not expect my growth to be this fast. I was expecting this to be much slower, and Will and this community have been a great assistance. Could not have done it without you guys. And yeah, up 200% on his account. He's grown from basically under 10 grand to over $30,000 in his account. That's just one of many testimonials we've seen over the last few weeks and months. So if you ever would like to learn, and whether you're a beginner or you're seasoned investor, it's a great place to start, and you can join us there. Send me messages if you have them. First link in the description, or second link in the description below to join StockMate. We'd love to see you there at Market Open. Let me know your thoughts on APLD down below, guys. If I earned your thumbs up, hit the like button. Do consider subscribing, and I'll see you in the next video. Take care.